Whatever you believe actually happened in Paris, one thing is very clear. The powers that be are going to try to use this event to expand wars, intensify domestic surveillance, and legislate away more of our rights. This is not speculation. They've already started in France, in the UK, at the EU level, in the US, and they are going to attempt to push this on a global scale, all nicely coordinated to ride the wave of outrage that followed the attacks. If you want a glimpse at just how far they want to take this, look at France. In France, they are already dealing out serious prison sentences to anyone caught saying anything that could be interpreted as supporting terrorism. Does questioning the official story count as supporting terrorism? Where do you draw the line? Who decides?
On parle beaucoup depuis quelques jours, Nathalie, d'unité nationale, mais attention, toute la France n'était pas dans la rue hier.
Non, Élise, faut pas faire preuve d'angélisme. C'est justement ceux qui ne sont pas Charlie qu'il faut repérer. Ceux qui, dans certains établissements scolaires, ont refusé la minute de silence, ceux qui balancent sur les réseaux sociaux et ceux qui ne voient pas en quoi ce combat est leur. Eh bien, ce sont eux que nous devons repérer, traiter, intégrer ou réintégrer dans la communauté nationale. Et là, l'école et les politiques ont une lourde responsabilité.
Oh, so you don't actually have to even support terrorism. Just disagreeing is enough. Come on, humanity. Do you really want to learn this lesson the hard way? Again? They are playing you people. Problem, reaction, solution. It's the oldest trick in the book. With so much riding on this story, obviously there are those who have a vested interest in preventing evidence that contradicts the official narrative from reaching the public. On January 10th, we uploaded a video entitled Charlie Hebdo Shootings Censored Video. Within 24 hours, it had over 1 million views. Then, the video was age-restricted and removed from most listings, in spite of the fact that it depicted no blood, no gore, no graphic violence of any kind. It did, however, present evidence which challenges the official narrative of the event. In spite of being age-restricted, the video continued to grow and added another 1 million views. We uploaded a French translation of the same video on January 12th. Within 1 day, the French version was taken down completely. Not age-restricted, not blocked in some countries, completely deleted from the site. Again, this video showed no blood or gore whatsoever. We proved this by zooming in and slowing down the footage. We're not going to show that footage again here. We're not going to give them any excuse to block this video. However, if you enter the following URL in your browser, you'll find a download link to the original files. Watch it and come to your own conclusions. Of course, there's much more at stake here than our little video, or even the Charlie Hebdo event itself. The internet as a whole poses a threat to the ruling class, because in its current form, ideas cannot be fully controlled. The internet in its current form makes it very hard for them to hide their corruption, their wars of aggression, and their covert operations, and that makes it hard to govern. They intend to change that, for your security, of course. Funny, isn't it? 17 people get killed in France, supposedly over an issue of free speech. And the first thing that governments of the world want to do is use that event to take away free speech on the internet. It's also funny that these same governments expressed no outrage whatsoever as the United States military killed hundreds of thousands of civilians in Iraq, Afghanistan, Pakistan, Yemen, and elsewhere. Apparently, it's not murder if you use a drone or a guided missile. Apparently, it's not terrorism if women and children are killed by soldiers and government bureaucrats.
We have heard that 500,000 children have died. I mean, that's more children than died in Hiroshima. And you know, is the price worth it?
I think this is a very hard choice, but we think the price is worth it.
Now, it's only murder when politicians and the corporate media tell you it's murder. And if they get their way, they'll be able to take down any website, video, or social media account that dares to contradict them. There's one question on many of your minds right now. What can we do? How can we fight back?
Well, first of all, stop waiting for instructions.
Do what you can. Use the talents you have. Get creative. If each and every one of you just did what you could, without worrying about whether or not you would succeed, that would be enough. Remember, these politicians don't have any real power. They just have your obedience. Even their enforcement arms, the police and the military, are really just structured obedience. Withdraw that obedience, and it's game over. This message resonates with you? Spread it. If you want more, subscribe to Storm Clouds Gathering on YouTube, or follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+. If you have a topic request, post it in the comments. And for the full transcript and sources, visit our website at stormcloudsgathering.com.